हेलो क्लास 7, आई होप यू ऑल आर टेकिंग गुड केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ। स्टूडेंट्स, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग लेसन नंबर 2 एटमॉस्फेयर, लेट्स क्रॉस चेक द आंसर्स।
एक्सरसाइजेस फर्स्ट, विच कलर इज यूज टू डिपिक्ट द एग्रीकल्चर फील्ड ऑन द मैप? येलो। सेकेंड वन, अ स्टेटमेंट स्केल ऑफ 1 सेंटीमीटर इज टू 1 किलोमीटर इज रिप्रेजेंटेड इन आर एफ एज 1:1 लाख। ओके सी। थर्ड वन सी, फोर्थ सी, फिफ्थ ए। फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स। फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स। फर्स्ट वन रेड, सेकेंड मैप एंड ग्राउंड, थर्ड वन रिप्रेजेंटेटिव फ्रैक्शन, फोर्थ हाइट अबव मीन सी लेवल हाइट, फिफ्थ वन कन्वेंशनल। फॉर डूइंग दीज टू एक्सरसाइजेस आई हैव ऑलरेडी शेयर इन लास्ट वीडियो। यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई दीज अल्फाबेट वॉट दे रिप्रेजेंट। ओके ए, वॉट डज इट रिप्रेजेंट दैट यू हैव टू टेल ओवर हियर। ए मेटल रोड, बट इट शुड बी इन रेड कलर। दीज आर द आंसर्स। ए मेटल रोड, बी ब्रॉड गेज। लाइक दिस ओनली यू विल डू इन योर बुक। ओके एंड दिस विल बी योर जी पार्ट। ओके दिस यू विल डू।
द मूविंग एयर इज कॉल्ड विंड। द ब्लैंकेट ऑफ एयर सराउंडिंग अर्थ is called atmosphere. Air, it can only be felt. That too when it is on the move. Moving air is called wind. Composition of atmosphere. Air is a mixture of gases. Nitrogen is the most prominent gas by volume. Most gases which is found in atmosphere is nitrogen. It constitutes 78% of the air. It is essential for the growth of plants. Components of atmosphere. Nitrogen, it covers 78% of the total amount of gas in atmosphere. Okay, oxygen 20.90, carbon dioxide 0.03%, argon 0.90, and other gases 0.17%. okay, this is the division of different gases which are found in atmosphere. Nitrogen is essential for the growth of plants. It also dilutes the oxygen and slow down the process of oxidation. Oxygen we need to breathe in for survival. For breathe in we need what? Oxygen. And it accounts for about 20.9 for the volume of air. This is the gas we need to breathe in for our survival. Along with oxygen, carbon dioxide is also the life supporting gas of the atmosphere. Though the proportion of oxygen is comparison to nitrogen and oxygen is very less, while nitrogen 78%, oxygen 20.90, and carbon dioxide takes only 0.03%. But its presence is very significant, very important. Carbon dioxide is not only utilized by the plants in the process of photosynthesis, but also what does it do? It also absorbs the heat. Otherwise, see what happened. In absence of carbon dioxide, days would have been extremely hot. Days would have been extremely hot and nights extremely cold. It is the heaviest gas in the air. Heaviest gas, that's why the lower layer of the atmosphere contain much more carbon dioxide than the upper layer. Okay. Carbon dioxide is found in the lower layer of the atmosphere. This also explains the reason why the temperature decreases. Altitude means height of the place from the sea level, and the hill stations are cooler than the plains. Hill station, they are located in height, that's why they are cooler than the plains. The other gases present is very small proportions in the atmosphere. They are argon, helium, ozone and water vapor, which along with carbon dioxide account for the remaining about 1.1%. The emission of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, the discharge of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is increasing day by day. How? Burning of fossil fuels, burning of coal and petrol in the present industrial area. Since carbon dioxide is a greenhouse gas, basically carbon dioxide is a greenhouse gas, it is leading to an increase in atmospheric temperature. But present time, what is happening? The quantity of carbon dioxide is increasing. This phenomenon means existence, is called the global warming. Global warming, warm, hot, global world. World is what is happening. World is becoming hot. It is leading to an increase in the worldwide temperature and consequent changes in the weather and climatic condition. And this, because of this disbalance, what is happening? Temperature is increasing. There are changes in we can see changes in weather and climatic conditions. Okay, pollen grains and the dust particles are the two major solid components of air. Pollen grains and the dust particle, these are the two major solid components of air. And what is the role of these two components? Pollen grains help us in the dispersal of seeds, dispersal, splitting of seeds. Dust particles help in the process of condensation. Dust particles, they help in the process of condensation of water vapor and formation of clouds. Salt particles are also present in the air near the sea. Structure of atmosphere. Atmosphere is held close to the earth due to the earth's gravitational pull. Okay, gravitational pull. Consequently, the atmosphere is densest near the earth's surface and goes on thinning upward. The atmosphere has been divided into four layers based on the density and at temperature difference within the atmosphere. Four layers are troposphere, the densest layer, okay, close to the earth. Surface of the earth is which layer? Troposphere. Then after, like, this is our earth, okay. The first layer is what? Troposphere. The first one is troposphere, and then second one is, then after, which layer? Stratosphere. Then after, mesosphere, and top of the layer is Thermosphere. Thermosphere is further divided into two layer. They are ionosphere and exosphere. Now troposphere. Troposphere is the lowest and the densest layer of atmosphere. Troposphere is the lowest and therefore the densest layer of atmosphere. Number two. These are features. These are features of this first layer, which is called a troposphere. Now second one, this is the only layer of atmosphere where water vapors and dust particles are formed. Third one, due to presence of these two elements, water vapor and dust particle, because of these two elements, all weather related phenomena such as cloud formation, wind movement and precipitation take place in this layer only. Forms of precipitations are dew, rain, hail, frost, fog. All these are forms of precipitation and they all take place in this layer. Which layer? Troposphere. Now number four, the height of this layer from the ground level is about 8 kilometer. Near the poles 8 kilometer and about 18 kilometers at the equator and 18 kilometer at the equator. Okay. The temperature of the air in this layer decreases with altitude. For every 165 meters, the temperature falls by 1 degree Celsius, which is known as normal lapse rate. The height of the troposphere decreases in winters and increases in summers. Why? Air expands when warm and contracts when cold. The boundary line between troposphere and next layer. And next layer is what? Troposphere, then next layer is stratosphere. Stratosphere, the height, the boundary between these two layers is called what is tropopause. What is called boundary between these two layers? Okay, this is called what? Tropopause. Now, after troposphere, then which layer comes? Stratosphere. Stratosphere is the layer above the troposphere, above the first troposphere, then stratosphere. It is considered the most stable layer of atmosphere as no weather related phenomena take place here. Due to the absence of clouds and wind movement here, all commercial passenger jet planes fly in this layer. In the upper part of the stratosphere, here is called ozonosphere. Okay. In the upper part of the stratosphere, there is a layer called ozonosphere, which contains the important ozone gas. Ozone absorbs the harmful ultraviolet rays of the sun and do not allow them to reach the earth. This is the role of ozone layer. Fourth, at the equator the air temperature in stratosphere is about 80 degree Celsius and about 45 degree in the polar region. Here 80 degree Celsius in equator. The temperature of an equator is 80 degree and about 45 degree in polar regions. Keep sending your assignments regularly. Stay home. Thank you.